We were talking about diabetes in the brain being Alzheimer's. What's really interesting to me is the fact that neurons are actually mostly using lactate from astrocytes. Astrocytes are glycolytic, so the astrocytes are supporting cells in your brain, which are using glucose, mostly are what using glucose to generate lactate. Lactate then gets shuttled into neurons. And then the neurons, and the reason why neurons like that is because it's thermodynamically favorable, much like beta-hydroxybutyrate, which you mentioned, BHB, because it can shunt right into the TCA cycle in the mitochondria.
By the way, how does the brain outcompete the liver for lactate? So like, if you go out and if I made you go out there and do a bunch of burpees, right?
Yeah.
So I'm blanking on the name of the transporter.
MCT.
MCT one or two, which one is the transporter out of the muscle?
I don't know which one, but
the majority of lactate is going to be generated in the muscle. So then that MCT is going to transport that out.
Yes.
And somehow, remember, it's got to go through the portal system.
Yes.
It actually doesn't go through the portal. It passes through the cava, but it's still passing through the liver. How does the brain manage to get any out of without the liver taking it all into the Cori cycle, which seems to me the preferential place to undergo gluconeogenesis?
Yeah. So what's weird is that I don't know the answer to your question. I know that many tissues, and this has been shown through the work of George Brooks at UC Berkeley, who actually pioneered the lactate shuttle hypothesis and the theory. But it's been shown that it gets taken up by the liver, it gets taken up by the muscle, it gets taken up by the brain. In fact, exercise itself has been shown to preferentially cause the brain to take up.
Can we measure, I don't know if you read this literature, but there was a lot of really interesting work back in the 60s done at Harvard with real fasting experiments.
Mm-hmm.
40-day fasts. So you'd have inpatient subjects given nothing but water and minerals for 40 days.
Yeah.
And it was done to basically demonstrate what the steady state fasting levels of glucose, insulin, BHB, and acetoacetate would be. And it's actually quite interesting, right? So you take a normal person, let's say your insulin level is, 10, your glucose level is 95, your BHB level is unmeasurable because you're on a normal diet. And your acetoacetate level is unmeasurable. And then we just fast you. And it turns out that within about 7 days, you'll be at a ketone level of 5 to 7 millimolar. Glucose will be down to 3 to 4 millimolar, which is, call it 60 to 70 milligrams per deciliter. And you will stay at those levels until at the end of the 40 days, they're still in those levels.
So they stay the same.
So the glucose never really goes away. What's changing is the consumption by the neuron, which goes from at the initial state being about 100% glucose. Of course, I don't think they were measuring lactate then, so we don't actually know.
Were they looking at neuron or just brain? Was it astrocytes or neuron?
They were probably just looking at brain, yeah.
Okay.
But it would fall to maybe 40 or 50%, the rest of it being made up by the combination of the ketones.
Yeah.
And it's interesting that it never went to zero, right? So even to your last day of life, if you're being starved to death, you still have glucose in your blood.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of interesting that, like, what percentage of overall brain metabolism do you think is driven by lactate? It must be very, very small and reserved for a very, very specific subset of neurons or astrocytes or...
Well, the astrocytes are using the glucose and they're generating the lactate. So the lactate doesn't
have to get in. Oh, so we're not even seeing that. So that might be the issue.
That.
So that's probably why the liver doesn't matter, because it's...
Well, during exercise, but it has been shown that lactate will cross over the blood-brain barrier during exercise as well. But that is why it doesn't...
But the dominant source is...
The astrocytes. The astrocytes are making it in the brain. And what's fascinating...
So astrocytes don't have mitochondria.
They do.
So why do they make all the lactate?
I think they make the lactate because the neurons, that's how the neurons are getting their energy. I think that's just the way it works
out. So it's sort of a Warburg effect. The Warburg effect, of course, to me is interesting because I don't buy the argument that the Warburg effect is due to defective mitochondria.
It's not. Warburg showed that.
No, there are still a lot of people who think that it's a that cancer affects the mitochondria, and that's why they work. But I think it's just that the cancer cell is smart enough, and it's optimizing for cellular building blocks. And it sounds like the astrocyte's doing the same thing.